This is the last unit of your syllabus, Basic Mathematics 2, Unit 4. Rectangular, spherical, polar and cylindrical coordinates, direction cosines, planes, straight lines, shortest distance between two is two lines and
sphere.
So, first we will see rectangular coordinates. See rectangular coordinates, first see the figure. This O, this is the point of intersection of x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. This is the origin. OX, OY and OZ, they are perpendicular to each other. There is a point P. The coordinate of point P are AB and C. So PM is perpendicular from P on the x-axis. PN is perpendicular from P on the y-axis. And PR is perpendicular from P on the z-axis. Therefore, this distance OM will be small a. This distance ON will be small b. And this distance OR will be small c. So this distance PN is small c. See, the three planes XY, YZ and ZX. This XY, this is a plane. YZ is a plane and ZX is a plane. They are perpendicular to each other with origin. Point O 0 0 0 means they are in, that is intersecting point. Angle OMP is 90 degree. See angle OMP, this is 90 degree. Angle ONP is 90 degree and angle ORP, this is also 90 degree. Therefore, OM is a small a, ON is a small b, and OR is a small c. This is all about your rectangular coordinates. You just switch off your mic. Next. Move on to spherical coordinates. See the spherical coordinates. First, see the figure. This is your x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. This is a point P. The coordinates of point P are r, theta, and phi. This r is distance of point P from the origin. This is a small r. This theta is the angle that PO makes with z-axis. Means angle ZOP is theta. And this phi is the angle, this one means take a perpendicular from P on the XY plane. So this is PM, join O to M. So this angle AOM is your phi, join A and M. See, PM is perpendicular to the XY plane. Angle POZ is theta, angle MOX is phi. Angle MOX, this is your phi. And OP is R. Then R, theta, phi, they are called the polar coordinates of this point P. If x, y, z be the Cartesian coordinates of P, then what will be x? X will be this OA. So what will be the value of x? This is OM. And this is your base. This is your perpendicular. This is hypotenuse. So this OA will be OM cos phi. So OA is equal to OM cos phi. And this OM, what will be this OM? Since this is angle theta, so this angle is 90 minus theta. This is R. This angle is 90 degree. So PM is R cos 90 minus theta, R sin 90 minus theta, and OM is R cos 90 minus theta. And R cos 90 minus theta is R sin theta. So this is R sin theta into cos phi. Similarly, Y is your AM. AM is this distance. So this will be OM sin phi, OM sin phi. And again, OM, value of OM is R sin theta. So this is Y is R sin theta into sin phi. And Z is your PM, length of this perpendicular. So this is your R cos theta. This is your R. R cos 90 minus theta is OM and R PM is R sin 90 minus theta. So it will be R cos theta. Why? Because R sin 90 minus theta is cos theta. Also, X square plus Y square plus Z square is R square because this is a sphere. This is the equation of a sphere whose origin is, whose center is 0, 0, 0 and radius is R. And now see that value of tan theta. This tan theta will be, this is your 90 minus theta. So this is theta. Tan theta will be this perpendicular by base, means OM by PM. OM is nothing but OA square plus AM square under root. So OM will be under root X square plus Y square. And this PM is Z. So tan theta will be root X square plus Y square by Z. And next tan phi. Tan phi is AM by OA, means AM is your Y. And OA is your X. So tan phi is your Y by X. So So this is all about your spherical coordinates. Next, we move on to polar coordinates. See here, see the figure. This is your origin O, OA, OY, and OZ. These are three axes. Again, we have a point P. Join this point P with origin O, and this distance is small r. This angle is theta. Angle MOX is phi. The quantities r, theta, phi are the polar coordinates of a point P in a rectangular coordinate system. Here OA, this OA is your OM cos phi, as earlier we have seen this. So it is r sin theta cos phi, and this is your small x. AM is your OM sin phi, this is r sin theta sin phi, this is equal to small y. And PM, PM is your perpendicular, this is r cos theta, and this is, it is your z. So r will be under root x square plus y square plus z square. And phi will be tangent inverse y by x. So theta will be tangent inverse x square plus y square under root by z. So this is all about your polar coordinates. Next, we have cylindrical coordinate system. See cylindrical coordinates. This is your O, X, OY, and OZ, perpendicular axis. This is point P. Coordinates of point P are U, phi, and Z. What this view? Take a perpendicular from P on the XY plane. Suppose this is PN. Length of this PN is small z. And join this point N with O. So this is your small u. And angle NOX, this is your phi. So U is, P is given as point P is U, phi, and Z. U, phi, Z are the cylindrical coordinates of point P. If P be X, Y, Z, suppose we write the coordinates of P in Cartesian system as X, Y, Z, then X will be U cos phi. See, this is your U, this is your OA, AN, the angle OAN is 90 degree. So OA will be U cos phi and AN will be U sin phi. So X is equal to U cos phi is equal to OA and Y is equal to AN is equal to U sin phi and Z is equal to Z simply. So here U is your under root X square plus Y square. Why? Because this is U will be OM means under root OA square plus AN square. So it is under root X square plus Y square. And phi is your tangent inverse AN by OA means tan inverse Y by X. So this is all about your cylindrical coordinates. After this, we will see concepts about direction cosines, direction ratios, straight line, plane, and sphere. So first, let us see some basic points. This is our OX, OY, and OZ, three axes, perpendicular axis. This is a point P, coordinate X, Y, Z. PA, PB, and PC, they are perpendicular from P on the x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. Therefore, OA will be X, OB will be Y, and OC will be Z. PN is perpendicular from P on the XY plane. Join this N with O. So, OA is X, OB is Y, and OC is Z. Now, distance between two points, A, X1, Y1, Z1, and B, X2, Y2, Z2, is given by AB is equal to under root X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square plus Z2 minus Z1 whole square. You would have studied this in your earlier classes. So remember those formulae and those points which will be used for in this portion. Coordinates of the point dividing the line segment joining the points P, X1, Y1, Z1 and Q, X2, Y2, Z2 in the ratio M is to N internally will be MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N, MY2 plus NY1 by M plus N, and MZ2 plus NZ1 by M plus N. If this is internally, then there will be minus in the place of plus. Now see the concept of direction cosine. See, this is your origin O, this is X, this is Y, this is Z, and OX, OY, and OZ, they are perpendicular to each other. This is a point P. This OP makes an angle alpha with the x-axis. This OP makes an angle beta with y-axis. And this OP makes an angle gamma with z-axis. This cos alpha, cos beta, and cos gamma, these are called direction cosines of this line OP. So the line OP makes angles alpha, beta, and gamma with the positive directions x, y, and z axis. Then cos alpha, cos beta, and cos gamma, they are called the direction cosines of the line OP. Also, we write cos alpha is equal to L, cos beta is equal to M, and cos gamma is equal to N. See, further, if P be x, y, z, if the coordinates of P are x, y, z, then cos alpha will be x by OP. X by OP, because cos alpha will be base by hypotenuse, and base will be x, hypotenuse is OP. Similarly, cos beta y by OP and cos gamma z by OP. So if you write OP is equal to R, so it will be under x square plus y square plus z square, then this x will be OP cos alpha. OP cos alpha means R cos alpha, and cos alpha is L, so x will be LR. Similarly, y is MR and z is equal to NR. So the point P is XYZ. XYZ means LR, MR, and NR. Also, L square plus M square plus N square is equal to, see here, x square, L square plus M square plus N square. See here, from L, value of L is x by R. So it will be x square plus y square plus y square plus R square plus z square by R square. So it is x square plus y square plus z square by R square, means it is 1, because this x square plus y square plus z square is 1. If LMN are direction cosines of the line, it is the condition LMN should be the direction cosines of the line, only then L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. Second, if L upon A is equal to M upon B is equal to N upon C, means LMN are in the ratio A, B, and C, then direction cosines will be plus minus A by root summation A square. Root summation A square means root A square plus B square plus C square. This is your first direction cosine. Second direction cosine will be plus minus B by root summation A square and plus minus C by root summation A square. Here A, B, C are called direction ratios or direction numbers. So remember, LMN, they are direction cosines, but A, B, C, they are direction ratios or direction numbers. So this is all about for today. You just make note down all of them, or you can take it screenshot also. In the next class, we will study some examples.